Your presence is my tea. We thank you for your grace. We share strength with you. We share strength with you. Sing your song now for a while. Sing your song until our hearts embrace. Sing along now for a while. Sing along until our hearts embrace.
Every 15 minutes is an opportunity for you guys to see something that's, you know, look really real. It's an opportunity for you guys to, that's on cue. It's an opportunity for you guys to see your friends go through something that you hope they never go through. And it's, you know, I'm sure, be honest, you know, for some of you it's a bit of fun too, you know, you get out of school for a couple of days, go down the football field, check out some cool shit. Let's be real about this, yeah? Yeah. Exactly. That's the truth. I'm not lying here. But for some people, it is real. You saw a video of me playing this song to my little brother in an ICU ward at John Muir Hospital a few days, or seems like a week ago now. Well, that happened for real. So that there, what you saw, for me, not for you, for you it was a video screen. For me, that was real. It can't ever be real for you until it happens to you. Some of you who stood up before, it's already happened to, you know. We've all got stories about these things that have been affected. You've heard all these consequences and stuff. But, you're in a special place right now, you know. You might be just in the gymnasium at your school, but you're in a special place here and here. Well, you're in a place of opportunity. And what I'm going to ask of you is, when I play you a couple of songs, I'm going to play that song again at the end, and we're going to approach it together, you know. But this is an opportunity for something to change within you. And it's not just about drink driving. My little brother, you know, what you saw was based on a reenactment, basically, you know, in a way, loosely. The Thursday at high school, the week of his crash, where his best friend died, where my mother drove along the road one night after a party they'd been to, she had no idea, and came across a car accident with a car wrapped around a tree. She resuscitated the driver. Good friend, good family friend, young lad, cool guy, really cool guy, you know. He got drunk and drove a car with my brother in the back seat, killed his best friend. But if he was to walk in here and that hadn't happened and you were chilling and you were hanging out with him, he's just like your man here. It's just like any of your mates sitting right beside you. So that's why when we get to the end of this, I'm going to ask something of you all. But so she found that accident, she revived the driver. She was aware that the other young lad was gone. He was gone. And she had no idea that her son, my brother, was involved in the accident. She was working on the driver, and another car showed up. And small town, they knew who he was, and they opened the rear door And they're like, that's Taylor Latimer. And so she was aware at that point in time, you know, that her son was there. And she spent the next 15 minutes, 20 or so, with his head in her hands on the side of the road, waiting for an ambulance to show up. It showed up, usual deal, what you guys saw then, you know, went through the procedures. There wasn't much hope for my brother. His head injury was extremely severe. Yeah, really, really severe. He clashed heads with his mate who passed away. So he gets flown down to the hospital and, you know, he's on life support, just like what you saw there. It was a bit full on for me watching that because everything that happened there, the little parts of it were coming back to me, you know. His band had a band rehearsal before the party that weekend and the whole deal. This is one of the main points I want to make about this, and you know, I don't want to freak out the organisers of this or anything. This is an amazing program, but I want to tell you guys something. This is just about me and all you crew, right? On Thursday, the same week of my brother's crash, they brought the fire brigade in, smashed two cars together and cut those things to pieces and went, you know what, kids? Ooh, look at this. This could happen to you, you know. The same week that he and his friends wrapped themselves around a tree, killed his best friend and he ended up on life support, they did a demonstration not unsimilar to what you've had here. And my brother was a smart guy, you know, as well. So this is way beyond this. What I want to talk to you guys about now, I don't want to talk much longer, I want to play a couple more songs because that's really where it's at for me. This is way beyond just the drink driving. This is way beyond what you're thinking. This is about a change in your gut and in yourself that actually shifts you and the way you approach when you're drinking and what you're doing when you're drinking. Because there's a prime example. You know what I mean? Prime example. And I pray right now that, you know, none of you go and do that a few days after a presentation like this, you know. But that happened. That's the truth. That's what happened. They brought the cars in. They smashed them up. They cut them to pieces. 4 days later, his best mate's dead. My brother's on life support. Drink, drive, crash. So you tell me what's going on. Because I'm just you. Except for real. You know, I was there, you know, playing that song to him every day. Doctors are saying, look, that's all well and good, but, you know, your brother sustained a head injury of a da 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 blah, 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 all this sort of stuff. But I knew, this is the truth, I knew within about a minute of walking into the ICU room that my brother was going to be a miracle survivor. So he was going to recover beyond any expectations for a head injury. Not only was he not going to die, or end up a vegetable, or end up mentally disabled to an extreme level. He was going to make a full and complete recovery. Now he has. He has. My brother is a certified medical miracle. And it's, yeah, it's... And you should clap. Exactly, yeah. Now he travels with me and my band, and we cruise around playing high schools, you know, like this, and we're going to come over here and do the same. We're not just going on about drink driving, we're just singing about life, man. We're just singing about life and just continuing to live it, not ending up 17 or 18, you know, passed away. But I want to move on to another story because, I want to come back to that. And when I come back to that song, I need you with me on that. I'm going to ask you guys to sing with me, whether you're humming it, whether you're doing whatever. I want to be a part of this with you. I've come halfway across the world here from Australia. Yeah. Thanks to the lovely people that organise this, you know. Thanks to the men and women who give their hearts and souls to put stuff like this on. Thanks to the emergency service people and all that that deal with this all the time, man.